Hello guys, this is Ravi. Today I am going to discuss the RE transistor model for the analysis of a transistor. There are different types of transistor model which is used for different low frequency signals and the high frequency signals. H parameter and RE model are used for the low frequency signals, while a hybrid pi model are used for the analysis of high frequency signals. Now I have taken a common emitter configuration transistor, and it has three terminals: collector, emitter and base. IB is the base current which is flowing through the base of the base terminal of the transistor, while IC is the collector current which is flowing through the collector terminal of the transistor, and IE is the emitter current which is flowing to the emitter terminal of the transistor. Here the voltage between the terminal B and emitter is shown in the figure as VBE, while the potential between the collector and the emitter is shown in the figure as VCE. Now we know that transistor BJT, bipolar junction transistor, is a combination of two diodes. When we connect two back-to-back diode, it will resemble like a transistor, as shown in the figure as NPN. It same resemble as this symbol of the transistor. Here in the NPN transistor, for the common emitter configuration, we are replacing the NPN transistor with its equivalent diode. Here we are considering the transistor is working in the active region, and the active region, we know that input side is forward bias, while the output side is reverse bias. Here now we are replacing NP with a diode and PN with another diode, where the top this diode is in reverse bias, while the bottom diode is the forward bias. And we also know that in this circuit there is a relationship between the output current and the input current with the beta. We know that beta means current gain for the common emitter configuration. Beta is equals to IC over IB. So in this configuration, we are replacing this the reverse bias diode with a dependent current source, and the lower PN transistor is replaced with a normal diode with a current emitter current flowing through it. We have also gone through the equation known as IC is equals to beta IB plus 1 plus beta ICO, where ICO is the reverse saturation current. Whereas the ICO is basically a reverse saturation current, and as compared to the collector current, we can neglect reverse saturation current because it is in microampere, while the collector current is in milliampere. In the common emitter configuration, we have seen the output characteristics of a transistor. In this output characteristic, we seen that the output resistance is basically inverse of the slope, means the output resistance of any circuit is inversely proportional to the slope of this curve. And from this graph, it has been seen that the slope is very small, or we can say that it is tending to zero. So if slope is tending to zero, then the output resistance will tending to infinity. Here we have seen that output resistance is equals to one inverse of the slope, and if the slope is tending to zero, then output resistance is infinity. So there will no current passing through the output resistance. Here it is shown in the figure, the output resistance RO will not pass any current through it, so the current will be zero from this R. In the given figure, it has been shown that this diode is in the forward bias, and the input characteristic of this common emitter configuration is similar to the diode characteristic. And this is shown in the figure. Here it is this is a input characteristic of a transistor which is similar to the characteristic of a diode. In this diode characteristic, we have calculated two types of resistances. there are two types of resistances, which is known as static resistance and the dynamic resistance. When we are dealing only with the DC signal, then we calculate the static resistance, and we are dealing with the AC signal, then we are calculating the dynamic resistance. Here the dynamic resistance has been shown, RD is equals to change in base emitter to voltage with respect to change in base current. Like if we have applied the input voltage, then there is a change in base current. Here this is delta IB and this is delta VB. So the dynamic resistance is change in base to emitter voltage with respect to change in base current. So we know that in the diode, the current flowing through it is represented by ID is equals to IS e to the power VD upon eta VT minus 1. This is also known as diode current equation. In this, VD is the forward voltage, where eta is the ideality factor and VT is the thermal voltage. The eta, the value of eta for germanium is 1, while the value of eta for the silicon is 2. Now, from this diode current equation, if we differentiate with respect to forward voltage, then with respect to VD, then we get this expression, where IS is the reverse saturation current upon eta VT, e to the power VD upon eta VT. And we know that change in current upon change in voltage is equals to 1 upon dynamic resistance, and this is represented by 1 by RD. For the germanium transistor, we have put eta is equals to 1. So from this expression, we know that from this diode current equation, we can replace this expression with respect to ID plus IS, and putting the value of eta is equals to 1. Then finally we got the expression 1 upon RD is equals to ID upon VD. We also know that the value of reverse saturation current is very small as compared to the forward diode current. The value of reverse saturation current is in the microampere or nanoampere, while the diode current is in milliampere. So we neglect the reverse saturation current with respect to the diode current. So this expression will become ID upon VT, where VT is a thermal equivalent voltage, and we also know that VT is equals to T upon 11,600. If we put T is equals to 300 degree Kelvin, then we get the value of VT is equals to approximately 26 millivolt. It is, the exact value is 25.6 millivolt, but we consider 26 millivolt in the round off. And this RD will become 26 millivolt upon ID. Here, so we have shown in the figure that this diode is replaced with the dynamic resistance. So we can also replace RD with respect to RE, in which the current flowing is IE. So the equation will become RE is equals to 26 milli upon IE, where IE is the DC equivalent circuit, for the DC equivalent circuit. Basically this type of model is also known as T model, because it resembled like a alphabetical letter T. That's why it is also known as T model. Now the RE model has been shown in the figure, where this diode is replaced with the dynamic resistance RE, and this reverse bias diode is replaced with a dependent current source, and this is output resistance. We have already seen that the output characteristic of a common emitter transistor, the slope is very approximately tending to zero, but it is not exactly zero. The slope is not exactly zero. For an approximate analysis, we can take the slope equals to zero, and the output resistance will tending to infinity. But for the precise analysis, the output resistance is not equals to infinite. The output resistance is not equals to infinite. RO is not equals to infinite, but it is in basically a mega ohm. So when we are doing approximate analysis, we can neglect this resistance, but for the precise analysis, we have to take this resistance. The value of resistance is in mega ohms. Now, in the given figure, we have to separate the input section and the output section. This is input section and this is output section. Basically, common emitter configuration is preferred for the amplification purpose because it will give the maximum amplification. Now, just moving towards the separation for this both for circuit. We know that the emitter current is the sum of collector current and the base current, and we also know that the relation between the output current and the input current with the current gain, which is beta, their IC is equals to beta IB. Now we have to replace this value of IC in this first equation, then we have got IE is equals to IB plus beta IB. Now taking common IB, then we will got 1 plus beta IB. The current flowing through this emitter resistance will be 1 plus beta IB. Then we have to find the voltage drop that appears across the emitter resistance. The voltage drop across this emitter resistance. So we know that V is equals to I into R. Now V is equals to, we can also put V is equals to RE into IE. By replacing the value of IE, we are putting beta plus 1 IB. From the below equation, where drop across RE is written as V is equals to R into I, where R is the emitter resistance and this is emitter current, then we are putting the value of IE from the above equation, which is 1 plus beta IB. So this whole expression will become RE into beta plus 1 IB, where RE beta plus 1 is the value of resistance and this is the current passing through the resistance. So in the given figure, we are replacing this resistance with a value of resistance beta plus 1 RE, and the current passing through this resistance is IB, and the voltage across is VB, while the in the another dependent current source, which has been replaced with this beta IB, and this is the output resistance, the voltage across this is the output resistance is collector to emitter VCE. So this is the final circuit for the RE model of a common emitter configuration, in which this is the input side and this is output side. The value of resistance is beta plus 1 RE. Here moreover, one more assumptions can also be done. The value of beta is much larger than as compared to 1, so we can replace this beta plus 1 RE with the beta RE, and this is the output section where a dependent current source having the value beta IB and the output resistance RO and the voltage across this RO is VCE, collector to emitter voltage. Thank you guys.